first photo of Halle Berry's injury as she leaves her lawyer's office. What consequences the Golden Globe winner could face from the alleged hit-and-run accident that left her with 22 stitches.
And this isn't the first time Halle has been investigated for a hit-and-run. We have information on her accident 3 years ago.
Who is the most powerful star in Hollywood? ET unveils Forbes magazine's new list of Hollywood's top 100.
And we'll reveal the woman who made number one with a $50 million paycheck last year.
All new celebrity splits in the Entertainment Tonight cover story. Whoopi leaves her longtime love. Inside Nicolas Cage and Patricia Arquette's bizarre divorce paper. The secrets behind the breakups.
There may be all sorts of little problems coming up now.
Woke up in Puerto Rico.
And it's a red hot homecoming for Ricky Martin as he plays Puerto Rico.
E.T. breaks Spin City news as Heather Locklear sets the record straight about her future on the show. Plus, we'll tell you who signed on for next season and the castmate who's still on the fence. Carson Daly gets a new job. We have the scoop on what the MTV star is doing now. The mystery multimillionaire is finally revealed as he marries his bride on national TV.
We'll tell you where the newlywed couple is tonight.
The Tom Cruise Oscar exclusive.
Now, who's the first person you called?
Yeah, I called Nick.
E.T. takes you behind the scenes on Hollywood's most nerve-wracking morning of the year.
How you doing?
Cider House rolls!
I've had a very exciting morning.
London, Las Vegas, Berlin. We go around the world to show what really happens behind the Oscar nominations.
And from Jim Carrey to Matt Damon, Leonard Maltin looks at the stars who were overlooked.
This is Entertainment Tonight, the most watched entertainment news program in the world.
And you turn around and look and you see a big army tank. I mean, it was something else.
Jesus Christ, there's a tank in my street.
And we saw all these cops coming towards us, like the OJ thing.
It rivaled a dramatic scene from an Arnold Schwarzenegger action movie. A hijacked 63-ton army tank on the loose, wreaking havoc on the suburban streets of San Diego.
What did I see? I saw my apartment complex, a tank running over my brand new truck, disintegrating it, as you can see, to nothing.
But when this extraordinary event was over, the real question was, who was going to pay for the damage?
I don't know. I don't have any tank insurance.
Monday on Hard Copy. They're here. The United States is an alien nation, and Hard Copy's mapping out E.T.'s favorite vacation spots from Seattle to the southeast. Find out where you're most likely to have a close encounter. Tomorrow on Hard Copy. What if you knew now which stars will walk home with an Academy Award? This guy claims to have a magic formula for picking the winners.
I'm as sure about Peter Fonda as I was about Nicolas Cage a few years ago.
So before you bet in that office pool, meet the gifted man who has the inside track on the Academy Awards. And the winner is...
Across the City of Angels, workers stop and watch in horror as news choppers capture the amazing scenes. The newsmen themselves even coming under fire at times. Police bring in combat-ready tanks. Streets all over the area are cordoned off. Finally, the white car stops. The gunman then commandeers a pickup truck, and the horrified driver runs for his life. Police race to the scene. Finally, another bad guy is down.
Hard Copy is your Seinfeld source.
I'm impressed.
We've got our eye on Jerry, an ear on the set, and our nose to the ground, ready to break a...
Hard Copy scoop.
We played pool with putty, campaigned with the real Kramer, and brought the soup Nazi to a boil.
It's not funny.
We're your Seinfeld connection, counting down to the final farewell.
I would like to thank all my Hard Copy fans.
Hard Copy is your Seinfeld source.
Hi, I'm Rusty Nails, and this is Katie Manor.
From the Breakfast Club at 91X, and if you listen in the morning, we're giving away $1,000 every day. And it gets easier if you listen all day long.
You have to listen! Listen to me!
And it's so easy to win $1,000 on 91X.
Go ahead, tell them. Jeez. $1,000 every day, 7:15, listen, here.
The cutting edge of rock, 91X.
Now, when you order the best prime rib in town, you get the biggest shrimp in town free. Your choice of tempura style with a light golden batter or elegant scampi style delicately sautéed. Either way, they make a big impression, complete with soup and salad and more. The biggest shrimp in town, scampi or tempura style, free with the best prime rib in town at Mountain Jack's.
30 years ago, the Marinos postponed a trip to the old country.
Still.
And visited Franklin First Federal instead.
We're late.
Maria was expecting, and they needed a bigger house.
It's only six.
Since then, we've helped them with student loans for college and a loan for medical school.
We're late. Come on, we gotta go. See?
Today, we're pleased to help their son, Dr. Marino, with a loan to send his parents to visit old friends in Naples, Italy.
Yeah, let's go, Dad. Come on, Mom.
You're just like your papa.
Come on, let's go. We gotta play.
But in one of these areas where leopards are found no more, the Kora Reserve in Kenya, a dedicated man is determined that leopards will continue to survive. This is Richard Widmark. Join us for the next hour as we see how Tony Fitzjohn is bringing leopards back to Kora. Kamunyo, on the other hand, remained dependent on Tony. He began to worry that she'd always remain a camp pussycat, unable to look after herself in the wild.
It's really sad that Attila is gone, but he was very capable of looking after himself. He chose to move off, and he's out there and having a great time. Obviously, you get very attached to your animals. Maybe one day I'll come back. Maybe one day I'll find him. In the meantime, good luck, Attila.
People seem to be my focus at this point in time, although color and light and the underlying design of the subject are what grabbed my initial interest. I find myself interested primarily in the fleeting commonplace, almost as if I'm looking for that which is happening every day around us, but that we're just not seeing. The viewer, I hope, in my work, the viewer takes on almost the position of being a secret observer, in that they're almost catching a glimpse of a quiet moment of living.
Not the last.